The Columbia River is a lifeline for many anadromous salmonids, including steelhead, Chinook salmon, coho salmon, and sockeye salmon. And during the right time of year on any given day, several of these species could take your bait.
Oops.
And today they're eating prawns.
Nice fish.
So with this prawn setup, I mean, it can be anything from steelhead to sockeye. We've been getting summer kings on it. There ain't a salmon or steelhead out there that don't want to bite a prawn. You know, basic cure for just doing these Atlantics is I'd always start with a quart jar, quarter cup of red hot double stuff with a eighth a cup of rock salt, and that actually does a pretty good durable starter cure for sure after the prawns have their color and they have their longevity. You can add whatever you want to them as far as other oils and stuff once you drain off the brine.
Here you go, girl.
The numbers of salmon and steelhead running up the river to spawn have fluctuated dramatically over the years, with much of that due to a combination of commercial fishing practices and the modification or elimination of spawning areas upstream.
Drop in there, baby.
Looks like another keeper.
My daughter, Emmeline, is about to land her first sockeye, which she has learned is the ocean-going version of the freshwater Kokanee salmon. Like a steelhead is the ocean-going version of a rainbow trout. Sockeye typically spawn in or in relation to a freshwater lake. Today, Wenatchee Lake in Washington is the primary spawning area. But in years past, sockeye spawned throughout the Northwest, including well into Idaho.
Nice fish. Beautiful little sockeye. Go ahead and get some slack on the line there. We'll drop them right here in the boat. This is a Columbia River sockeye. We haven't been able to fish for these for the last few years, but in the last 3 years, the returns have been really strong, and they've been allowing us to target and keep these fish. So, it's kind of a different thing that we've been experiencing here for the last few years. So. Good job.
Sockeye salmon like this typically range from 3 to 6 pounds, but recently, Emmeline had the opportunity to travel upstream to a special little lake in eastern Oregon that once was a major natural spawning area for the sockeye, and now has produced the world record kokanee caught by Ron Campbell at almost 10 pounds. Wallowa Lake is well over 400 miles from the mouth of the Columbia, and Emmeline's made the run upriver to fish for Wallowa's giant kokanee with record holder Ron Campbell and Gary Miralles of Shasta Tackle.
I got him. Well, this is an interesting little kokanee, but he's, for Wallowa Lake, that's a pretty small one.
So obviously, good questions about Wallowa are, why would this lake grow world record size kokanee, and will it continue to do so? Today, we're fishing Wallowa Lake, home of the giant kokanee. I'm Justin Wolf, and this is Angler West Television. Following the route of a sockeye salmon heading to Wallowa Lake takes you from the Columbia River to the Snake River and then into the Grand Ronde River of eastern Oregon. And then a push up the Wallowa River eventually leads you to one of the prettiest spots in the West, Wallowa Lake, with the Eagle Cap Wilderness area as a backdrop. Wallowa's huge runs of sockeye and coho salmon once supported two canneries, but this natural migration route and runs of salmon were eliminated with the building of this dam in 1906. So what remains are the indigenous kokanee that have been supplemented with planted fish over the years, which today partially spawn in the lake but primarily spawn in the upper Wallowa River. One theory for why the kokanee have grown so large in the past few years is that a landslide that occurred in a prime spawning area of the upper Wallowa River dramatically reduced the number of kokanee, which meant there was less competition for food in the lake, which in Wallowa is a combination of plankton and freshwater shrimp. In addition, the introduction of mackinaw, who prey on kokanee, also reduced the numbers, allowing the surviving kokanee to grow to enormous size.
Look at this little one go. And you know, these spawn right up the river right over here. Did you know that?
This year, while some giants have been caught, there are many more smaller fish being hooked, which means the spawns have been more successful.
Here's another small fish.
But does this mean that the fish will not grow as large?
Crickie in the park here and spawn starting in about September.
Only time will tell.
That's pretty small. We'll let that one go.
Welcome back to Wallowa Lake. I'm Justin Wolf. World record kokanee holder Ron Campbell and Gary Miralles are helping my daughter Emmeline with her first experience on Wallowa Lake for kokanee. And that begins with getting the right bait in the water.
Hold that can for me. And what these little devils are little live maggots. See the little white worms? They're kind of yucky little things in a way, but boy, do they catch fish. And they're hard to put on the hook because they're so little. Just put them on like that. I like a lot of them because they give off a lot of scent in the water. And that's why the fish like them. And plus, I think they can see them squirm if they're alive. So, I'm getting a fish right now while we're talking.
That one's fighting good. Maybe we better throw that in the box and give you another one deep. What do you think? Well, we're fishing, you know, a bunch of different baits today. We'll be running sling blades, mostly UV, a variety of squid baits or hoochies, the coconuts, and some spoons. Starting out right now with a glow pink coconut, and we'll put a little maggot on the back there that adds a little extra flavor. Throw a little Procure scent on there too, and we're good.
Kokanee special. So we caught that last one.
You know, the sling blade dodgers are designed for actually faster speeds, but we use them a lot, of course, trolling slower too. Today we're going to be running about 1-2. And what we do is basically take the dodger, and you can actually put a pretty good bend in it, kind of just add a little more cup to the back. This will give it a harder throw at that slower speed, so they'll produce just as well as they would at a faster speed. You know, there was a 9.5 caught out of here, I think it was about a week ago, which is a wonderful fish, but so far we found it pretty tough this week, primarily because of the weather, I think. It's had a lot to do with it. You know, one day it's cloudy and raining, the next the sun's out like we have today, so the barometer's just been bouncing up and down. And kind of got the fish off bite though, but I like what we're seeing today. You know, it's looking stable today, and we might just have a good day.
If you happen to get lucky and catch a world record, whether it's Wallowa Lake or anywhere, you got to really start thinking about what you're going to do with it. I had a real issue when I caught mine with weighing it. The first scales I weighed it, I weighed at 9.485 pounds. The second scale weighed at 9.67 pounds. Well, so there was a discrepancy between the scales. Well, at least in the state of Oregon, the Department of Agriculture certifies scales for 2 years. Now, IGFA only recognizes the weight from a scale that's been certified within the year. So if you go and have your fish weighed, you must check the tag on the side of the scale to make sure that it's been certified within the year. If it has not been certified within the year, IGFA will not recognize it. What they told me was, they said, we're sorry, we won't recognize either weight. I said, what am I to do? And they said, have them recertified. So I was very fortunate in that they were about due to be certified, so the state of Oregon went ahead and recertified both scales. And as it turned out, the heavyweight was on an accurate scale. So the 9.67, interpreting to a lot of people don't know, on records, you have to they change it to ounces. So 9.67 pounds is 9.10 ounces, a little bit over, but they round it off. So 9 pounds, 10 ounces. A lot of people hear a weight. They say there was one caught up here last week. We talked about that. It was 9.1 pounds. In reality, when that's converted, it's 9 pounds, 5 ounces. So you have to keep that in mind also.
Now, Ron, that fish that they caught here the other day would be the third largest, if it is found to be exact, that would be the third largest ever caught?
The fish caught the other day at 9 pounds, 5 ounces, would be an ounce smaller than the one caught in Canada 22 years ago, which was 9 pounds, 6 ounces.
Oh,
I can't even get it straight here.
So that was real close to being the second largest. Wow.
Real close to being the second largest
fish. Isn't that amazing?
Yep.
You know, Ron, Al Vosa caught that 9 pounder last week, sent me an email on what he caught it on. And it didn't surprise you, I'm sure it was on a UV sling blade, but it was on a yellow scorpion spinner that he had apparently painted some kind of a rainbow pattern on the blade. But so I thought I'd better give you a couple of those. I know you've got these, but better give us some of those scorpion spinners just in case, huh?
That's interesting that you mentioned that, because in 2000, my brother caught the state record Kokanee out of here, and he caught it on a rainbow spinner.
Oh, really?
So that makes me ask myself, is there something to that?
Oh, yeah. Well, Ron, you were doing so well on that pink double glow peewee that I switched over to a pink coconut. And as soon as I put it down there, fish on.
Well, I'm trying to teach you here what really works.
There you are.
You're the net man. I'm driving here.
There you go. I can do that. Well, that's fighting pretty good, huh? Is that fun?
Yeah.
Yeah, it's a good time, huh? You know, Ron, this is what really makes fishing great, getting kids out and letting them enjoy what you and I grew up enjoying. And it's just a lot of fun to see Emmeline out here having a great time.
That's half the fun of fishing, Gary.
Oh, yes, it is.
Getting the kids out.
You know, my father started me when I was, 5 years old, and I still remember the first fish I caught, you know. This is a decent fish, hon. There we go. Oh, boy. There we go. Wasn't that fun? All right. Good job. Good job. You know, Emmeline, we're fishing at about 15 feet here. So what we do is we hook these up to the weight on the downrigger, and then we drop it down to the depth where the fish are, and that's how we catch them. And what we have to use to do that is a release. And this is an ultra release. Okay, this is a great release for kokanee because you can set them real light, and I'm running some light line today. And the best way to use these, we adjust that screw to the diameter of your line so it's almost closed there. We make a loop. After we let your line out, you make a loop, twist it. I just kind of roll my thumb up, little lip to the back. We set it right there, then pull into the slot there, and then that's all it holds it. When a fish hits it, tightens that right up, pulls right out.
Downrigger release clips might not be too interesting to an 8-year-old, but a gondola ride up the side of a mountain, now we're talking. The Wallowa Lake Tramway takes you up the steepest vertical lift of any gondola in North America, to the top of Mount Howard, at an elevation of 8,150 feet. Once on top, a short walk gives you an incredible view of the Wallowa Mountain Range in the Eagle Cap Wilderness area. At this elevation, the trees are dwarfed by the harsh climate, but there is a surprising amount of life on top of the mountain. The Wallowa Lake Tramway is a great way to spend a morning or afternoon, and there is lunch and snacks available on top of the world. And if you hang out long enough, you'll definitely make a few friends. The tramway is located right next to the Eagle Cap Chalets, which is a great place to stay. Contact the Eagle Cap Chalets about the tramway and other activities like horseback riding, which can easily be done all in the same day, or just get out on the lake and go fishing. Besides kokanee, Wallowa is stocked heavily with rainbow trout. and many trophy hunters troll the depths for big mackinaw. This specialized boat is used to distribute many of the fish evenly throughout the lake, and bank anglers generally have good luck with
that's
these planters.
The first for me right there.
Today, we're on the water with Gary Miralles, Ron Campbell, and Ron's brother Larry. And with a couple of days of stable weather working, we're hoping to finally lock into some of Wallowa's bigger kokanee. And of course, setting a new record is never out of the question.
You know, in this lake, we've got some large kokanee, obviously. And so today I'm running some 4-pound P line. It actually breaks at 6-pound. And what we're looking for is a possible fish that's up in around that 6-pound class. And we catch on this, then we have the shot at a line class world record. And it could be the day.
Well, this year has been a real interesting year as far as weather. I don't know if summer's ever going to come here or not. It's and we have a fish on right now while we're talking. Might be a little one if he's still on there. The last year, these dates in June, the fish were just red hot. Did really well. I know one morning last year I caught 18 kokanee in the first 3 hours, and that one morning five of those were over 5 pounds, and one of them over 7. This year I haven't had that experience, and so are the fish declining again? Is that happening, or is it the weather? So I think within the next 3 to 4 weeks, we're supposed to have some wonderful weather next week. We're going to know whether there's a lot of big ones still in here.
Yeah, look at the marks we got on that deeper water.
There's a lot of big fish laying in the holes.
Let's stay out a little bit deeper water maybe and see how that goes.
So we're in 33 right now, and it's coming up. So we're going to have to, it's always the problem with our ball, watching that.
Oh, yeah. You know what we can do is we'll drop in and out of these holes with our downriggers. We pay attention, and we'll be able to maybe get one of those bigger fish.
And that's actually where we're catching them.
Yeah.
Just because they're kind of laying in there like that and finding a comfort zone for some reason.
Sure.
Welcome back to Wallowa Lake. I'm Justin
Wolf. I dropped
Wolf.
Right down onto the bottom there.
Gary Miralles and Ron and Larry Campbell are on Wallowa today, specifically looking to catch those big kokanee that so far this week have been elusive for most anglers. With a more stable weather pattern locking into place, the bite is definitely picking up, and hopefully that means bigger fish as well.
A little bigger fish.
With everyone spooled up with 4-pound P-Line CX line, hopes are high that one of the many fish coming to the boat will be over 6 pounds and therefore in contention to be a new line class world record fish.
Now it's a coke. That's nothing wrong with that fish. There you go.
I lost it.
Hug that puppy. Here he comes.
All right.
Boy, that's a piece of fish. Made that turn and I thought, whoa, I think I snagged something on that turn. And next thing you know, it started taking some line. And I'm on 4-pound test here, so I've got to be careful. Here we go. Let's see. Oh, not quite. Hold on with the net. Hold on. Here we go. There you go. That's what I'm talking about right there.
Yeah, that's a dandy there.
I've spent
that's a birthday.
5 days out here fishing.
Birthday
finally
fish.
Finally got one of those. Excellent. Good job. Good decision on the spot to go to. Good job,
dandy
buddy.
Dandy fish there.
Throw your butt in if you keep out fishing me.
I love
good
it.
Good job.
What do you think we got on weight there?
Good 3 pounds.
Yeah. That's a beauty, man. Wow, what a beauty.
Nice kokanee, Gary.
It's on that pink coconut, and that UV silver blade. That's a nice fish. It is really tough to catch a kokanee that size anywhere in Oregon except here. At least I don't know of any other place. But that's a beauty. Wow. Good fight, too.
While not nearly a record fish, this is a prime example of the quality kokanee found in Wallowa. And it just so happens that Shasta Tackle Pro Staff member Brian Russell, who was out fishing in his own boat on this day and was using 4-pound P-Line CX line, did hook that fish Gary was looking for and set the new line class world record with this fish that weighed in at 7.47 pounds. Regardless of whether or not Wallowa is kicking out record fish or just lots of good eaters, it's now legal to stack two rods in Oregon, so the Shasta Tackle Shuttlehawk can be a big help.
You know, Larry, this is the Shuttlehawk. I mean, this is a downrigger diving device, and I use it primarily for stacking two rods. You know, now in Oregon, of course, you can stack two rods here. So what we do is it comes with this release, and you adjust that screw to the diameter of your line, and you know, after you let your line out, what I do is make a loop, and then I spin it so it twists. And there's a little lip in the back. I lay it up against that, pull it down in. It just kind of pops in there. That just kind of grips it there. And hook it on the downrigger, slips in on that slot, and when you drop it in the water, the angle downward, you keep tension on it, that's what makes it dive. Now as you're dropping down, you want to keep tension on it. You can either loosen the drag on your reel and just like let the clicker go, you know, and it'll dive, or you can keep your thumb on it, fall it down. But you could take it down to whatever depth you want and then just lock it at this speed, or you could put a stop on the cable and it'll go down to that stop. Sometimes you'll put it 10 feet above the bottom, you know, your bottom lure. But anyway, it's great for stacking. And when this releases, it actually returns to the surface so you don't have to crank your weight up. So it allows you to fish two rods in that without having to constantly bring up that when you hit your second rod.
There couldn't be a nicer place than Wallowa for trophy hunters to analyze the conditions and to chase world records. But if you'd rather, you could just go fishing. Thanks for watching today's episode of Angler West TV. You know, it's only with the sponsor support that the show is made possible, so please thank them when you can. Now get out there and do some great fishing.